Though different in many ways, Africa, with all its myriad challenges if resolved, comes off as the best candidate for the next world's biggest economy. Hence, the need to explore all that the continent has to offer for its youth. Starting from the East, which opens its doors to FinTech initiatives, businesses, tourism, and intra-African trading, the African Continental Free Trade Agreement holds the potential of connecting 1.3 billion people across the continent with an economic powerhouse of $3.4 trillion to lift 30 million people out of extreme poverty. Highlighting on this, Eric Osiakwan, managing partner of Shenzo Capital, believes the African continent offers a market for young entrepreneurs to leverage on technology to lead innovative businesses. In effect, they have made investments in some businesses in East, West, and South of Africa and are working with governments within the sub-region to create a conducive environment for startups to thrive.
If they can do it, we can do it as well. And they use technology, and technology is all about brain power, right? So for the first time, the youth of Africa are really taking on this challenge that we can use technology to solve problems in Africa. You have a big market, but you need to grow businesses that take advantage of the market. And that's why we invest in these entrepreneurs, because we believe that they are going to be the next successful business.
According to Chris Sananu, cross-border trade in the East of Africa have been made easier with the use of a common currency. However, for the survival of the pact, member countries should encourage the use of digital currencies. He also added that an increase in travel experience for young Africans will broaden their knowledge to work with each other, hence positively impacting the economies.
Getting digital fiat or digital currencies working across Africa is going to be a thing, you know. So we may not necessarily have a Pan-African currency in the physical format that people expected, but having digital currencies that we can use across Africa is definitely going to happen. The first step, which I totally believe in, is we need to get our youth to travel more, to be more exposed. Because there's no way I'm going to do business with somebody in Ivory Coast if I've never been to Ivory Coast and I don't understand the orientation. It's difficult. It's not impossible, but it's very difficult.
Paul Barclay Okori emphasized on the importance of digital payment platforms as it makes the transfer of money on the continent easier. However, he says to ensure consumers are confident and secure on these digital payment platforms, there is the need to continuously build the platforms to minimize the occurrence of fraud within the cyberspace.
But from the trading side, there's also the movement of people side, which is very important and a key ingredient to trading, as it were. Cybercrime is an ever-changing, it's always an ongoing concern. Like you'll not say that we've made it, we've done it. We are continuously working on, continuously improving our systems, and continuously seeing that those kind of attacks don't happen, because then when they happen, they reduce the confidence that customers have in technology.
Samuel Johi urged young entrepreneurs to master their art in order to reap the benefits of a unified economy. He also impressed on government to look beyond their interest and focus on the pact with optimism.
If we are to really realize the dreams we have for Africa and for prosperity, and you know, stop sort of being beggars and actually become, you know, net contributors, we all need to put our selfish interests within our own countries behind us and really think as a block, and that's the only way then we can leverage the capacity, the numbers, and the size and the resources we have in Africa for everyone's benefits.
As Kenya youth moves towards a more entrepreneurship-geared movement, these pacesetting entrepreneurs are leading the way, and I hope you look no further, for we have it all in Africa.